Well, I was born in 1986. What if I just did my whole life? I first started explaining things to myself out loud. I talk out loud to myself all the time. I distinctly remember being on a family vacation when I was in elementary school. And I was in the hotel room alone, and the bathroom had one of those, like, you know, clean, sealed for your protection pieces of paper around it. I said out loud, "This paper is put here so that you feel like the toilet is cleaner." And like, I said this out loud as if there was an audience listening. I remember this moment because it was the first time that I went, why am I doing this? I'm not talking to anybody. I think verbally expressing and explaining out loud was what gave me the ability to better understand things and appreciate them. And so I would just do that even when I was alone. When I studied in college, I would give the lesson out loud, and if I couldn't explain it easily myself, I probably didn't understand it well enough. In fact, when I research a topic for an episode, I over-research it. I've always done a week of research on the topic, and what I wind up saying in the episode is just a fraction of what I could have said. Because if I don't over-research it, I don't know it well enough. I should be able to have anyone come up to me and say, wait, could you clarify this? Or, well, wait, what about this? And I need to be able to say, yes, of course, good question. So the reason I didn't include that is because I figured it out and blah, 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 blah. You know, if I only know what I say, then it comes through because I don't truly understand the whole thing. In high school, I participated in debate, but I wasn't that great at it because I'm not very organized. This has been a theme of my life, but we had another program called forensics. Forensics means dealing with the court and law. Forensics as a high school extracurricular was basically just competitive speech. One of the kinds of speeches you could give was an informative speech, which informed on a topic. And you could inform on the history of something, you could inform on an upcoming event or a charitable cause. And what I would do is pick a completely mundane, goofy topic. The first one I ever wrote was on ketchup. And I don't know why, but everyone thought it was hilarious that I wrote this 8-minute speech just about ketchup, its significance to society, the viscosity of it as a condiment and why that affects its ability to come out of certain containers, why is it spelled different ways, how should it be pronounced, who invented it. And this went on and on and on, and I treated it so seriously. It was almost like a comedy routine.
Hey, fellas, listen to this letter. Gentlemen.
That ain't for us. We're not gentlemen. Speak for yourself.
Oh!
But that was when I found what I was both good at and loved doing. What I do now on Vsauce is the exact same thing.
Hey, Vsauce. Michael here, and my tea is quite hot. But it's not the hottest thing in the universe. So what is?
It's like I'm back in high school again, but instead of one new speech every year, it's a new speech every week. I think someone once left a comment that was like, man, Michael could talk about paint drying and it would be interesting. It turns out that paint drying is very interesting. At a microscopic level, it's fantastic to see how the paint and the water in the paint interact. And so I've always kind of taken on challenges of, this episode sounds silly, I know, but just watch it and you'll see how fun it is. Stick around because there will be more videos of me right here on Thinker. In fact, the whole channel has some pretty cool stuff, the ideas and thinking that are changing the world, so be sure to subscribe.